gentlemen, prepare for a magical experience unlike anything you have ever seen. Prepare to be amazed, amused, and mesmerized by the comedy, the magic, and the illusions of Cody Fisher.
All right, let me make some noise. Come on, let me hear it. Hear that group over there. Let me hear this group over here. Let me hear everybody. Awesome, awesome. How are you guys doing today? Awesome. My name is Cody. Welcome to here and say good morning, Cody. Anybody's name, and I need some volunteers to come up here and help me with some. Well, that's never a problem. Hands down. I need to know some names. So on the count of three, can everybody please tell me your name? One, two, three. You know, I always do that. I always forget, but it always reminds me. If we're all talking at the same time, are we going to be able to hear each other? No, if we can't hear each other, we're not going to have a good time, and more importantly, we're not going to be able to learn today, which is very important. So we have to have a few simple rules, but they're easy. First rule is you have to have a good time. If you're going to have a good time, say yes! Yeah! I promise we're going to have a good time. Second rule is how I choose volunteers. Throughout today's program, I'll pick one or two, maybe three people to come up here on stage and help me do some magic. Now, I'm going to find volunteers. I'm going to find boys and girls who are seated on their pockets with their hands in their lap, backs in their straight, big smiles on their faces. Awesome. Got a lot of good-looking volunteers. Now, my last rule is my silly rule. At the end of all of my tricks, I'm going to say, that's the end of that trick. When you hear me say, that's the end of that trick, you're going to bow your head to the right like this. Bow your head to the right. That way. Bow your head to the right, you're going to go, oh. Let everybody try that. What do you do? What do you and I say? That's the end of that trick. Aww. Now, if I think you're having a good time, if I think you're learning a lot, I'll say, but I brought another trick. When you hear me say, but I brought another trick, put your hands in the air. Woo! We're going to shake out that energy. Put your hands back down your lap. Make sure you're on your pockets, backs up straight, eyes and ears up here. Big smiles. Are you ready to start the show? Awesome. Well, before I start any kind of educational show like this, I always have to have a little disclaimer because way before I was a magician, I was a school teacher for many, many years, and it's very important we understand what magic is. How many people think because I can do some magic tricks that I have magic powers? Okay, some people do. Hands down. I want you guys to be very clear on this. I don't have any magic powers, but I can do magic tricks, and I learned how to do these tricks by going to a library, section 793.8, and checking out books on magic. So if after today's show, if you feel like you want to do a magic show for your mom or your dad or your grandma or your grandpa, go ask your librarian where the magic books are, and he or she will show you where the magic books are. Do you understand? Say yes. Yeah! All right, well, let's do this. I want to share with you one of the first tricks I ever learned, and I always use this as a warm-up trick because there's a lot of people here today, and we have to learn how to work together as a group so we can learn how to learn together as a group. And I'm going to do that by sharing with you one of the very first magic tricks I ever learned how to do. Would you like to see it?
Yeah!
Now, back when I was your age, learning how to do magic, I didn't have any special cards, but I did have some Uno cards. So this is the very first trick I ever did at my very first magic show. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was 10 years old. It was in my parents' basement. There were five people seated on the ground eating triangle sandwiches and drinking orange Kool-Aid that my mom made. And I walked out on stage and I said, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please share with me as I count my Uno cards. And we all counted together like this. One, two, hold on, we have to work together. Let's do this, here we go. One, two, three, four, five Uno cards. I remember though, I took one of those Uno cards and I tossed it into my grandpa's hat. Yet when I snapped my fingers, believe it or not, I still had, help me count. One, two, three, four, five Uno cards. Everybody in the crowd, they were so amazed, they took their right hand, they clenched into a fist, they shoved it in there, and they said, amazing! All right, that was pretty good, But I said, we have to get ourselves warmed up working together as a group. We have to do it at the same time and with a bunch of energy. Can we work on that?
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to give you another chance to work together, and I'm going to do that by telling you a true story of the first magic show I ever did when I was a kid. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was 5 years old. It was down in my parents' basement. There were 10 people seated on the ground eating square sandwiches and drinking grape Kool-Aid that my mom made. And I walked out on stage and I said, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please share with me as I count my Uno cards. And we all counted together like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Uno cards. I remember I took one. I took one. No, it wasn't one. Now that I think about it, no, it wasn't. It was actually two. I took two Uno cards and dropped them in my grandpa's old hat. Yet when I snapped my fingers just like that, believe it or not, I still had. Help me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Uno cards. The audience was so amazed. Everybody took their right hand. They clenched into a fist. They shoved it in and they said, you know what? That was way better than last time. That was very good. But let me tell you the observation I saw and why it's so important, especially for today, actually every day. I saw almost everybody in here was participating. There were a few people that did not participate. Boys and girls, take it from me, not just today, but in your normal classrooms. When you participate, you learn more. When you participate, you have a better time. When you raise your hand, you always learn more. Do not be afraid to do that. I'd like to get everybody in this room to get their hand in the air and give me an amazing. Would you like one final chance?
Yeah!
I'm looking for 100% audience participation before we can go on. And I'm going to give you that final chance by telling you a true story of the first magic show I ever did when I was a kid. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was 2 years old. It was up in my parents' attic. There was 1,000 people seated on the ground eating cheese pizza and drinking Sprite. And I walked out on stage and said, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please help me count my Uno cards. And we all counted together much like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Uno cards. And I remember I threw one of those Uno cards into my grandpa's, no, like last time. It was two Uno cards into my grandpa. You know what I think about it? Actually, it was three. You know what? It could have been four, I think. You know what? It was five. It was five. No, it wasn't five. I think it was six. No, it could have been seven. No, maybe it was seven. No, I think it was eight. You know what? I know how many it was. It was nine. It was nine Uno cards into my grandpa's old hat. You guys are paying attention now. Yet when I snapped my fingers just like this, believe it or not, I still had, help me count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Uno cards. Everybody in the audience was so amazed. Everybody took their right hand. Everybody clenched into a fist. Everybody shoved it in. They said, amazing! Give yourselves a big round of applause. And that was definitely the end of that trick. But I brought some more tricks.
Yeah!
Well, boys and girls, I'm so happy you're here today. Teachers, thank you for showing up here because I really want to talk to you guys about being a positive friend, how to recognize a positive friendship. But before we go into that, before we get into my three key talking points, I think the kids want to see a little bit more magic. Yes?
Yeah!
Well, besides seeing magic, because we're in school still, would you like to learn some magic? Awesome. Well, I tell you what, I'll teach you how to do a magic trick, but we have to take the magician's secret oath, because magician is an art form. We must respect that. Everybody raise your right hand and repeat after me. Say, I. State your name.
Promise.
That even though. I'm going to know.
How this trick works.
I won't tell anyone.
And I promise.
Never to say,
never say
what
other people
tell me to say. Thank you for being here, sir. Here we go. All right. To do this trick, I'm going to teach it to you. To do this trick, you're going to need two simple props. You're going to need a magic wand. And again, this isn't really a magic wand. My wife calls this a $25 stick. No powers. The second thing you're going to need is you're going to need a little white handkerchief, and I got this from my grandpa. So here's what you do. You walk out on stage, and you say, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I have a little white handkerchief. You run the handkerchief through your hands once, twice. On the third time, you take the little handkerchief and you stuff it into the top of your fist, just like this. You point to someone on the front row, and you say, ma'am, Name a color. Name any color in the world.
Blue.
And it comes out the other side red. Fantastic, fantastic. Red was the correct answer. That's okay. Watch very carefully. I could have turned it to blue. I just didn't feel like it. Watch. It goes in the top red. I'm sorry, in the top white. It goes out the bottom red. In the top white, I'm going to teach you how to do this. Out the bottom red. It's changing colors as it's going through. You know, I, like you, the first time I saw this, I was so amazed, I also forgot to applaud. Stunned silence. I'll do the last little bit in slow motion. Watch, 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 watch. That's my watch. Watch. I'm going to place a little white handkerchief in here just like this. I'm going to pull it out. You'll see the white change from white all the way to red, and the white one is completely vanished, just like that. Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. What? My hand is wide open. There's nothing inside my hand. Now, oh, I like questions. That's, you guys are paying attention. I like that. That means you're paying attention. You guys think the white one's here. Would you like me to check?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be honest with you. Nope, it's not there. Okay, now, the way the trick works is, oh, man, I like, you guys are really inquisitive. Okay, I tell you what, I'll open my hand, but only if I hear enough clapping. You guys look really confused. That's okay. It's magic. I'm going to show you how I do this. Now, I don't really change the color of a handkerchief. I can't really do that. But what I can do is I can use two handkerchiefs. I'm going to teach you how to do this. Watch, watch very carefully. Watch. When no one is looking, you take and put a handkerchief inside your fist. You do this when no one is looking. This is the secret part. It can be any color at all, as long as it's red. Here we go. It just goes in here just like this, okay? Now, you take the white one and you wave it up and down. Whatever you do, don't open this hand or they're going to see what? Yeah, no, don't open this hand because they're going to know that you have two handkerchiefs. So you keep this hand closed into a tight fist. Now, take the white one. What?
The red one.
The white one's right here.
Where's the red one?
The red handkerchief is right there inside my hand. All right, I think you guys are getting confused, and I do not want to confuse you today. So I'm going to leave the red one sticking out the bottom just a little bit so you can keep one eye on it. Now, when you perform this trick for your friends, don't leave it sticking out the bottom because you're not going to fool them, okay? So walk out on stage, wave the white one up and down like this. Place the white one on top of the red one. Now, look, if you have two handkerchiefs, and if you push the white one on the top and you pull the red one out the bottom, it looks like an optical illusion, like the handkerchiefs are changing colors. They're not changing colors. They're actually just changing places. But you know what? You guys forgot to ask me what the magic wand is for.
What?
I'm so glad you asked me that. The magic wand is for this. Sometimes I get about halfway through, and somebody says, open your hand. If they want me to open my hand, they're going to see I can't. You're right. Unless I have a magic wand. If I tap the red and I tap the white, now I can open up my hand because I don't have a red one or a white one. I just have one that's half red. And that's the mystery of the color changing handkerchief. Thank you guys very much. Thank you guys very much. How did I do that? I tell you what, hold on a second. There's at least one person here that looks is not as impressed. Because that you didn't say, what color did you say? She said blue. I could have changed it to blue. I just didn't feel like it.
Do it.
Okay. Okay, all right, here we go. That's good, that's good. On the count of three, everybody shout out a color for me. One, two, three. There's your blue. Is the color changing handkerchief. Thank you guys very much. And that was the end of that trick. But I brought some more tricks. Awesome. Well, boys and girls, check this out. I want to show you another trick, but I want to do my favorite thing. I love to do magic, and I also love to teach. I use so much magic in my classrooms as an educational tool that I just can't help but do it now. But I'm going to use these three pieces of rope to show you how your brain works. Because here's the deal. If we wanna understand why we do certain things, or why certain people do certain things, like maybe somebody calls somebody a name, or somebody picks on somebody, well, we have to know why we do that. If I just tell you why, it's not good, but if we can understand why, it's even better. Now, I'm gonna undo these three pieces of rope. They're tied into a knot, and I don't want you to say anything about it. I just want you to look at the three pieces of rope. Don't shout at anything, just notice something. I want you to look at the rope like you look at something every day of your life. Watch, this is rope number one. Don't say anything about it. Just look at it. Observe it from the top to the bottom. Just look at that piece of rope. Now, hold on a second. This is rope number two. Maybe you can look at rope number two, compare the two. Rope number one, rope number two. Don't say anything about the ropes. Let's just look at it. Look at those two ropes. Last but not least is rope number three. Don't laugh at rope number three. Here we go. There's rope number three, goes right over here. We have rope number one, rope number two, rope number three. Now, we look at stuff every single day. Can somebody here, don't shout it out. I want to know, raise your hand if you can tell me the first thing you noticed about these ropes, the first thing you noticed about these three pieces of rope. Let me see. What's the first thing you noticed?
The first one was bigger than the other two.
So they're different sizes? Raise your hand if that was the first thing you noticed. Raise your hand if that was the first thing. I find this amazing. 20 years of doing this, no matter what age group I bring this in from, the first thing anybody ever notices about these ropes is how they are different. Here's what I find even more amazing, hands down. After 20 years of doing this, nobody has ever said to me, Cody, all these ropes have white tips. They all have that in common. Nobody's ever said, Cody, they're all black in the middle. They all have that in common. Nobody's ever said, Cody, they all look like magic wands. They all have that in common. Nobody's ever said to me, Cody, the most obvious one, they're all made of the same kind of fabric or material, cotton. They've got that in common. If you look at that, they have more in common with each other than they do that are different. Yet what do we notice? We notice the differences. Do you think we do that with people too? I think that's just how our brains work. We notice things that are different. And you know what? I'm here to show you that these ropes actually aren't so different, just like we are not so different. And for that, I need to get a volunteer from the audience. Somebody come here and help me do this magic trick. Raise your hand if you'd like to help me. You see, you know, the young lady who told me they were different. You come up here, give her a round of applause. She comes up here. You see? Can you make it up here? Be very careful. Very careful. All right, come stand right here. Give her a big round of applause. The first star of the show. You're the first star of the show. Hi, what's your name?
Kaylee.
What's your name?
Kaylee.
Kaylee, my gosh, that's a pretty name. That was my name when I was a little girl. I'm just joking. I'm joking. Here we go. Okay. Kaylee, let me see. Now, since we already noticed that we're good at pointing out differences, you know what? Now that we know that we do that, maybe we shouldn't do that with people. Instead of looking at us and seeing how we're different, we wear different clothes, we may live in different parts of town, we may show up to schools in different kinds of cars, that doesn't matter. What's on the inside is what matters. I'm going to show you that these ropes are exactly the same. Hold up one finger here, and I need you to point to the shortest one. Where's the shortest one? Where's the medium-sized one? Where's the medium-sized one? The one in the middle. Yes, and where's the great big long one? Just like that. I'm going to mix the ropes up now just a little bit. Let's see if you can still find these differences. I'm going to go really fast now, so you have to listen very carefully. Where's the shortest one? Yes, where's the medium-sized one? Yes, last but not least, where's the shortest one? The shortest one. We have to listen very carefully because I'm sometimes tricky. That's okay. That was me. That was my fault. Here we go. Watch. Now, boys and girls, the way you learn how things are similar is we get to know somebody. We ask questions. And you know what? If you start asking enough questions to enough people at your school, you're going to find out you've got way more in common than you are. There's differences. And the more things you have in common, the more friends you're going to find out you have. I'm going to bring these three ropes from the bottom to the top. We're going to make them equal. Matter of fact, I'm going to bring the bottoms from the bottom to the top. We're going to make the bottoms equal. And it just looks like these ropes are the same size. But we need a magic word. Do you know a magic word I can use? Do you have a magic word? Do you know a magic word? Does anybody? Just raise your hand. Hold on. Hold on. Shh. I don't know. What's your magic word? Hold on. I can't hear what she's saying. Shh. What'd you say? Did you say have a banana? Did she say have a banana? I thought she told me to have a banana. Now, bananas are great. I like, but I don't want a banana. Here we go. I tell you, we'll use abracadabra. That's better. Here we go. Here we go. That's just okay. Here we go. So stand right here. Wave your hand up top. You guys are paying up to me. Say abracadabra. Hocus pocus. Chicken bones chocus. And just like that. Shh. if we turn these three ropes inside out and we look at the inside, you'll notice they look very similar on the inside. Just like once you get to know someone, rope number one looks a heck of a lot like rope number two, which looks very similar to rope number three. Boys and girls, if we can spend most of our time focusing on our similarities and what we have in common and less time on what we have that's different, I guarantee you, you're going to have a lot more friends in your life. Give this young lady a big round of applause. She goes back to her seat. Awesome, awesome. Well, check this out. I want to do another rope trick here, but I want to take a little break from all the education stuff, and I want to share with you some really cool knots. You guys like knots?
Yeah!
Well, I learned how to tie a lot of really cool knots back when I was your age and I was in the Girl Scouts. Watch this very carefully.
You're in the Girl Scouts?
I'm just joking! Here we go.
Watch.
Here we go. Watch. The first knot is called the impossible knot. Do you know it is impossible to tie a knot in a piece of rope if you never let go of the ends? Don't do it now, but later on, grab a string or a shoelace and hold on to the ends. And no matter how much you twist it, how much you turn, if you never let go of the ends, you'll know it's impossible to tie. Never say the word impossible while you're at school. That's a cool knot, but that's not the coolest knot. Would you like to see the coolest knot I can do? All righty. This next knot here is called the world-famous one-handed granny knot because it's not as world-famous. It was taught to me by my granny. Watch, here we go. One hand behind my back. I'm going to tie a knot in this rope in less than a second. One, two, three. What can I say? I got a really cool granny. That's a cool knot, but that's not the coolest knot. Would you like to see the coolest knot I can do? That's not it. That was just gravity. It's the law. Here we go. Watch very carefully. The next knot I'm going to tie is called the world-famous jumping knot, and I like this knot a lot because this knot's going to help us teach a lesson about how the type of friends we surround ourselves with. This knot can actually jump. Would you like to see it jump?
Yeah!
Watch right here on the count of three. The knot is going to jump up in the air on the count of three. Watch right here. Don't blink or you're going to miss it. It happens very fast. One, two, 3 weeks ago, I was at a different school, and they all blink. Don't blink. This is very important. Here we go. On the count of three. One, two, 3 days ago, I was at my grandma's house. And okay. I just don't want you to miss this. Here we go. I do this just for myself sometimes. Here we go. Watch. One, two, three. Did you see it jump? Did you see that? You guys are really smart. There's no fooling you, and I don't want to fool you, but listen. But wait a second. Wait a second. I am going to show you this knot can jump, but that was a silly way. I want to show you this knot can jump in a magical way. Just like, hold on a second. My mom used to always tell me when I was younger, she used to, even to this day, she would say, hold on. My mom used to always say, it's very important with the types of friends you surround yourself with. And I wasn't sure I 100% understood why. And she would say, if you surround yourself with friends that have bad habits or a bad influence, those could rub off onto you. And I wasn't sure. I was like, well, I was a pretty good kid. And so I wasn't really sure what that meant, how a bad habit could jump from one person to another person. But it is true. You want to surround yourself with people who do positive things, not with people who do negative things. Now I'm going to show you what this looks like using this piece of rope. Pretend this rope is a friend of yours or someone that you know. Pretend that this knot is a bad habit. I've got another piece of rope here that's going to represent you. What color is this rope?
Red.
You are correct. That is red. And what is this?
Red.
That's right. That's white. Okay, here we go. Check it out. Did I get them backwards?
Red.
So this is red and this is white.
No.
I had it right the first time. Okay, watch. White, red. Check this out. This is a friend of yours. That knot's a bad habit. We don't want to surround ourselves by negative influences. This is you. You're perfect. If you stay far away from bad influences, can they get to you?
No!
Chances are not. But what if maybe the person you hung around the most, maybe your best friend, you hung around that person a lot, and that bad habit got really close to you. It got super duper close to you. See, when we surround ourselves, look at that. Watch. 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 Watch, watch, watch that knot on the count of three. One, two, three. That knot jumped from you, from your friend over to you. Now you got this bad habit. Do you want this bad habit?
No.
No. So when you find yourself doing something you don't want, that you don't like, the cool thing about it, at this age here, you can go to your mom, your dad, your grandma, your grandpa, your aunt, your uncle, your teachers, your counselor. You say, you know what? I don't like this behavior. Can you help me fix it? And they will help you get rid of that bad habit just like that. You know what? And instead of focusing on the bad, let's focus on the good. Let's feel this is our rope of life. Let's fill it with good habits, like staying in school. Is that a good habit?
Yeah.
Doing your schoolwork?
Yeah.
Being a good friend?
Yeah.
Not being a bully?
No.
Yes, watch this very carefully. If I take that little good habit there and I squeeze it right there, just like that, it sticks. And you know something? If you do something for long enough, it's not just something you have to consciously think about. That good habit becomes a permanent part of who you are. Boys and girls, fill your rope of life with good habits and positive friendships. Thank you. Give yourselves a big round of applause. And that was definitely the end of that trick. But I do have another trick. All right, and for this trick, I'm going to need a volunteer from the audience. Somebody who's very strong, very brave, somebody who believes in themselves. Let me find somebody over here. Let me see. I'll get somebody from the front. Let me get somebody back here. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see. I'm going to find somebody. Like so many good-looking volunteers, I can't choose. So many good-looking volunteers. Can you help me, this guy over here? Yeah, will you help me do a trick? Can you help me? You help me, yeah? Come on. Give him a big round of applause, boys and girls. Be very careful. Very careful. All right, star number two. Hi, get up here. You're the star of the show. What's your name? Everybody give Joel a big round of applause for coming up here and helping me out. All right. Joel, I want to talk about now, we already know that we tend to look at differences. So now that we know that that's how our brains kind of work, we're not going to look at differences anymore. We're going to look at how people are similar. And when you do that, you always have more friends. But we're going to take it one step further, because sometimes it's hard to do the right thing. And sometimes you're not sure what the right thing is. And that has to do with peer pressure. How many people here have heard the word peer pressure? Raise your hand. Awesome, awesome, hands down. Well, back when I taught a life skills class when I was teaching, here's what I noticed, teachers. I noticed that the kids, when I asked them if they heard the term peer pressure, they all could tell me that they've heard it. It was a very familiar thing because we say it all the time. But what, more importantly, when I asked them to describe what it is or what is peer pressure, I got very little understanding of what peer pressure actually is. And so I thought, instead of just giving you a definition, I thought today we would do a magic trick where we get to see peer pressure and see what it feels like. Do you guys want to do that?
Yeah!
All right. Well, I've got here my peer pressure prediction. I can't show this to you, my friend, but I will show it to everybody else. You'll see it in the end. This is a playing card. It's a great big playing card, but I can't show it to you just yet. Don't shout it out. It ruins the trick. I'm going to leave that right there. You can see it. I also have some jumbo playing cards right over here, just like this. Can you guys see these cards? They're super duper big. Come stand right over here for me. Here's what we're going to do. We are going to try and simulate what peer pressure looks like in an exaggerated way, because we tend to remember things that are exaggerated. So in just a second, I'm going to have you pick one of these cards, and you have to try and pick the card that matches my peer pressure prediction. But we're going to make it more difficult, because sometimes life's a little bit more difficult. Every time I hold up one of these cards, everybody in the crowd is going to scream out, pick that one. That's the right one. But you don't know if they're lying or telling the truth. They may be trying to play a joke on you. You know, sometimes when your friends try to get you to do something, you don't know if it's the right thing. So, what's the right thing? Is what your mom tells you the right thing to do? And your dad, yeah? And your teachers and counselors, is that the right thing? Yeah. Usually you know what the right thing is up here. More importantly, you feel the right thing to do right here. So here we go. I'm going to hold up these cards. And every time you guys see one of these cards, I want you to say, pick that one, pick that one, pick that one. And I guarantee you, as long as you believe in yourself, you're going to make the right decision. Not yet. Here we go. Nobody ever gets it wrong. Here we go. Here we go. Ready? Here we go. And go, go, go. This one? No, no. He's not going to fall for that. Here we go. I'll try to. This one here? No, no. Here we go. You tell me which one. Which one do you want? This one here? This one. Are you sure? Oh my gosh. Boy, this is what it feels like sometimes. You got all your friends telling you, do this, do that, do that. And you just have to, sometimes you just have to say, no, I'm going to do what I know is right. You could have had any one of these cards, but you pick this one. Free choice? I think it is a free choice. Come stand right here. Stand right here. Hold the card just like that. Don't let anybody see it just yet. Hold the card like that. Boys and girls, here's our answer. Here's what we're supposed to do. We tried to tell him the right thing to do, but he made up his own mind. And when you do that, you always make the right decision. Turn the card around. Show everybody that you made the right decision. You chose the A. Huh? Are you playing a trick? Are you playing a trick on me?
You cheated.
All right, wait a minute. Hold on. This is kind of like what peer pressure feels like in real life. I'm serious. When a whole bunch of your friends are doing something and you decide to do something else, it may feel initially like you made the wrong decision. But hold on. As long as you do what you know is right, you always make the right decision. And you make the right decisions when you have confidence and you believe in yourself. On the count of three, everybody watch my prediction. Everybody on the count of three say, I believe in myself. One, two, three. Boys and girls, making the right choice is definitely not a magic trick. All you have to do is have confidence and believe in yourself. Give my volunteer a big round of applause. You definitely made the right choice. You may go back to your seats. A big round of applause. Stand right here. You stand right here. Awesome. Hi, what's your name?
Gabriel.
Gabriel, awesome. And what's your name?
Sydney.
Oh my gosh, that's my middle name. Okay, here we go. Check it out. I'm just joking again. Okay, here we go. Hold on. Okay, let's talk about what we learned about so far. So far, we learned about noticing our similarities and not our differences. We're going to focus on that. And we also learned about how we sometimes do things, not because we really want to, but because our friends are trying to get us to do that. That's called peer pressure, and I think you're never going to forget that. Now I'm going to talk about, here we go, I got some cards over here. Put this right over here. I want to give you a very special playing card here, And it's special because it doesn't have anything on here. It is a blank playing card that you are going to create something here. Do you like to write? Do you like to draw? Okay, I'm going to cap that like that. Don't get it on your hands. It's a permanent marker. You hold the card just like that. And when I call some things out, you either write the word or you draw it, okay? So the first one here. How to be a good friend. What are you looking for in a friend? Everybody hold up your hand. Hold up your hand. Draw a hand or write the word hand. Hold up your hand and repeat after me. A fantastic friend?
A fantastic friend.
Is someone who always lends
A helping hand.
When you're trying to be a good friend and when you're looking for people to surround yourself by, try to find people who are always there for you. Not people who are always there for them, but when they need you, you know that you can count on them. That's the kind of person that you want to be from now until the rest of your life. And if you do that, you will have lots of friends. Okay, we have the hand. Do me a favor, draw a mouth or write the word mouth. Point to your mouth. Point to your mouth. I want you to remember this. Here we go. Repeat after me. Say, a fantastic friend. Is someone who
always says
nice things about you. It seems so simple, folks, but that really is one of the secrets to having a lot of friends. Do we want to surround ourselves by people who call us names?
No.
Do we want to be the kind of person who makes other people feel lousy? No. We want to be around people who build us up and who make us feel strong, who tell us we're great, you're awesome, cool haircut, awesome sweater, awesome shoes. Look at that smile on his face. If you do that to somebody every single day, you're gonna get that smile, and it's gonna make you smile. So always say nice things. Okay, the next one here we have is ears. Point to your ears and draw an ear on there for me, an ear. Point to your ear, repeat after me, say a fantastic friend.
is someone who
takes the time
to listen to you.
That is very important when you're deciding who you want to be and who you want to hang out with.
You don't want to be around somebody who's always talking about themselves, like, I'm so great, I'm so great, I'm so great. Is that fun? No. You want to be a good listener. I always learn more when I listen. I always learn more when I listen, okay? And we have the hand, the eyes, and the mouth. Boys and girls, everything you need to know about being a good friend is right up in here. Now, we're going to take these things because they are so special. And we're going to fold them up, right? I don't think there's any other card in the world that looks like that has your artwork on there. We're going to fold the thing up just like this. I'm going to give you guys both something really super duper cool. You want to hold on to that for me? Squeeze it tight. And I'm going to give you guys both something. Stay right here. Let me see. I'm going to give you a purse. I'll give you this first. You take this. Take this here. Take this here. I want you to hold on to the card, but I do not let it go. Hold on to it tight. Hold on to it tight. Excellent. Do you have a purse with you? You bring a purse? That's okay. My grandma gave me a purse. Well, it's not like, you know, she gave me a purse, but my grandma gave me this little purse. Here we go. Now I want you to verify, is there anything inside that purse? No. Is there anything inside there? No. We're going to close it up just like this. It's a very safe place. I also need something else here. Here we go. I need you to do something very careful. These things, the fantastic friend stuff, they're so valuable. We want to hold our friends very close to our heart. You have a heart on your shirt, I noticed. Can you take this box and just hold that really tight? Put your arms around it. Don't let anybody get that. Because we're going to take these characteristics. Boys and girls, it's no secret to getting friends. It's all right here. But we're going to make them vanish and keep those ideas in a very safe place. Watch. Is it gone? Okay, hold on. Not yet. We'll try it again. Watch. Is it gone? Okay, thanks for helping out. No, that's okay. I tell you what, we'll try something else. On the count of three, just drop the card. 1, 2, 3, drop it. Did you feel that? It vanished from the handkerchief and reappeared in a very safe place. Go ahead, open up that purse. Check it out. The secrets to being a fantastic friend. Is it in there? No, I said it's going to reappear. Very safe place. You've got something there held very close to your heart. May I have the box, please? Watch. This box is sealed all the way around with the most impenetrable substance on the planet. Duct tape. And inside here, I keep something very special. I keep a box. Because boys and girls, friendship is a gift. And it's so special. These ideas I'm sharing with you are so special. They're so valuable. I keep them locked up. I keep them locked up in a very special place. A very special place. A very special place. You know what? I keep them locked up. If you look down here inside the last box, there's a little box that has a lock on it. And my grandma, besides giving me a purse, my grandmama, she gave me a key. There happens to be a key right here. Now, you know what? These are very special secrets, and you should never tell a secret to anyone, but this is a secret I want to share with you. It's how to be a good friend. And how to recognize a good friend. Go ahead and open up that card. Open it up for me. Written on that card is that the secrets of friendship right there. Hold it up so they can see it. Boys and girls, don't keep friendship a secret. Go out and make as many friends as you possibly can. Give my volunteers a big round of applause as they go back to their seats. Here we go. You can keep this. That's your artwork, yes. Now we're getting that trick. But I have one final trick. And of course, I need a volunteer from the audience. Somebody who's not afraid of wild animals. Are you okay? You okay? Yeah? Come on up here, buddy. Come on up here. Watch your step. Come on up here. Come on up here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, our last and our final star of the show. What's your name, star? Vaughn. If we give Vaughn a big round of applause. We got a very special trick just for you, Vaughn. Let me see. Vaughn, do you like animals? Oh, you're going to love this next trick here, Vaughn. Check this out. Reach there and grab any card. Touch your card. I'll tell you which one it is.
Six of spades. I'll do it again. Try it again. It's a good trick. Just grab a card. Tell you what it is. Six of diamonds. It's better if they're face down. I realize that. Here we go. Take the card right here. Just from the face of that, put your initials on there. Just put your initials or draw a picture. Something, know that that is your card. Boys and girls, a lot of magicians have a card trick where somebody takes a card and somebody tries to find a card. I wanted to do something. That's okay. It's just a floor show. I wanted to do something that was even so special that I don't find the card. I have an assistant who finds a card for me. You said you guys like animals. Do you like bunny rabbits?
Yeah.
There is not a bunny rabbit in this basket. Do you like puppy dogs?
Yeah.
There is not a puppy dog in that basket. Do you like kitty cats?
Yeah.
There is not a cat in that basket.
It's a rabbit.
Do you like boa constrictor snakes? You're gonna love this next trick then, because I had to get special permission to even bring this here. It is a red tail boa constrictor snake, and I taught him how to do a card trick. It's really cool. Check this out. In just a second, my snake's gonna crawl out of the basket. You're in the Home Alone look. Here we go. He's gonna crawl out of the basket. He's gonna dig through these cards and find the one card that you wrote your name on. Okay, stand right back here. I'm gonna give you a magic wand. You're gonna take the magic wand. You're gonna wave the magic wand in a circle over the basket. When you do, the snake's gonna crawl out of here, crawl around here, crawl around here, find the card you wrote your name on. Fair enough? Take the magic wand and wave it in a circle over the top of the basket just like that. Here we go. It needs to be a clockwise circle, not a counterclockwise circle. Just wave it in a circle just like that. Just wave it in a circle just like that. Just wave it. Just wave it. Just wave it. Just. Right here. I'm trying to play a trick on you and you're playing tricks on me. Here we go. I have another wand. Always be prepared. Here we go. Take a wand. Hold it tight like that. Wave the wand at the basket. Give me that. Stand right there. All right, wait a second. I got a magic fan. I got this from my grandmama. It's an antique. Not my grandma, the fan. Don't call her that. Here we go. Watch. Don't sling it open. You could break this. It's very delicate. Okay, here. Hold one hand here. Hold one hand here. Open the fan nice and wide. Wave the fan up and down at the basket. I'm welcome. All right, wait a second. Hold on a second. That's okay. Hold on. I have another one right here. Here we go. Check this out. Hold it really tight. Here we go. Wave the one. Oh, come on. This is not fun.
It sounds like a
bar.
It sounds
all right. Like a bar. Wait a second. He's not going to break this one, boys and girls. This is super duper. Here we go. Heavy duty. Take the wand. Wave it. Hey! Get over. Stand up in here, man. What are you? It's the last trick of the show. You're playing me. Oh. All right. Wait a second. Let me make sure that my snake is even in here. Hold on a second. Stand back. Kazam. Kazam. Shh, he's asleep. I gotta wake him up. He's asleep. Okay, it's your turn. Here we go. It's your turn. Here we go. Okay, here we go. The way we're going to make the snake come out of the basket is you're going to hold up one finger. Hold up one finger. You're going to tap on the cards three times. Now, you do it in slow motion. You be very careful when you walk over there. You never know what a boa constrictor jumping snake is going to do. Okay, here we go. Hold up one hand like this. Here we go. Tiptoe over there in slow motion. Tap three times and then tiptoe back. Did you see that? Did you see that? Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! It's okay, folks. It's okay. It's okay. There it is. There it is. You were braver than I was. I screamed. I think I screamed. Here we go. Boys and girls, inside my snake's mouth is a playing card. Not just any playing card, but a six of diamonds. Not just any six of diamonds, but one with that. Oh, hold on. One with this guy's information on it. Boys and girls, please give my friend a big round of applause as he goes back to his seat. Woo! That was the end of that trick! That's the end of the show! But it doesn't have to be the end of the fun. Everybody put your hands in the air!
get rid of some of that energy. Go, woo! Shake it off! We gotta get on a bus in a minute. Let's get rid of it. Go, woo! One more time. Woo! All right, put your hands in your lap. Put your hands in your lap. Big smiles on your faces. Crisscross applesauce. Boys and girls, when I say goodbye, here's all I want you to do. I want you to look to the left, look to the right, find your teacher, and he or she's going to help you get out of here in a nice and orderly manner. Thank you guys so very much. Teachers, thank you for your time today. Thank you guys.
Let's hear it for Cody Fisher. Cody Fisher. Big round of applause for Cody Fisher.
Thank you guys.